Double delta connection. This we use for 3-phase to 6-phase transformation. This is our primary side. This is our primary side. This is our secondary side. Primary side is star connected and the secondary side split into two parts each phase. Okay. Now the primary is star connected. So we are connecting A1, B1, C1 together. A1, B1 and C1 together. So this is our neutral point and A2 is our input. We are taking B2 as input. This is our A, B and this is our C. Now let's come to the secondary part. The secondary part is split into two parts. So first part we are taking it as A1, A2, B1, B2 and C1, C2. Now let's see how we will be connecting this. Now these are star connected. It's delta connected. So since it is delta connected, so what we will be doing? A1 of the first is connected to B2. This is the last part. So A1 is connected to the end B2. A1 is connected to the end B2. B1 is connected to the end C2. So A1 is connected to the end B2. And B1 is connected to the end C2 and C1 is connected to the end A2. Okay. So our first part is connected. Now the second part, that is this, this and this, they are reverse delta connected. First was delta connected. So in the first part what we did, A1 first part is connected to the last part for all the three things and the outputs we took as A1, B1 and C1. So this is our output A1, B1 and C1. This is our output, three terminals. Now for the second part, it is reverse delta. So end A4 is connected to start B3. So end A4 is connected to start of B3. Let's take it from here. B3. B4 is connected to start A3. B4 is connected to start of C3. Okay, and the last part, C4. It is connected to start A3. Sorry for the poor diagram. And the outputs we took as A4, B4 and C4. And C4. So this is our double delta connection. The only problem is, since the secondary side is star delta connected, so we don't get any neutral, for which we cannot use it so effectively in rectifier circuit. Okay.